Let me show you how to integrate your form with Zoom. So follow me to my desktop right now. Welcome to Job Form. My name is George, and on this video, I am going to show you how to integrate your form with Zoom. This way, you'll be able to schedule meetings and even webinars. So it's going to be super easy. All we have to do is follow these steps. So let's get started. This is my main workspace here on Job Form, and we are going to get started with a brand new form. We are going to have to add a few elements into this form in order to integrate. So I'm going to start from scratch with a form, and I'm going to select the classic form for this purpose. Now we are going to first name this form so we can locate it later on. So in this case, I'm going to name this Job Meet. Okay, here we go. We're going to keep it simple. Let's go ahead and add the elements that we're going to need. So we are going to need the full name, the email, and appointment feature. Plus, I'm also going to add a long text. This way, they'll be able to add some information that will be useful for us in the future. Okay, so here we go. So we got the name, email, the appointment section. Now, this is a really crucial part of the options here in the appointment element. Go into the gear icon for the properties, and we are going to set up a few steps in order for us to fine tune the way that they can make an appointment. Now, in this case, we're going to get started with the availability option. So first off, we got the appointment slot duration. That means that when someone schedules a meeting, it's going to lock in a slot of 60 minutes. Now, that could be enough, or that might be too much. You can go ahead and bring this down to 15 minutes, 30, 45, or custom minutes in case you want to set your own slots. Okay, so in this case, I'm going to leave it to 30 minutes. And then we have the intervals. Right now, it's set to 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. We can change this really easily by just clicking on this and changing the timer here. So I'm going to change this instead of 9 a.m. We're going to kick this off after 10 a.m. in this case. So 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. And then we can set the days that we want to have this available. So for example, in this case, it's set to Monday through Friday at this time. But maybe Saturdays, we want to have a different interval. So in this case, I can add an interval here, and I can set that on Fridays, it's going to be 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. And we're going to set this. So again, we're going to remove these. Here we go. And we are just going to set Saturday. So we have a different interval for Saturday. Then we have the lunchtime. Do we want to keep a lunchtime? In this case, we can turn this on or off. In this case, it's set to 12 p.m. to 2 p.m. So that means that no one will be able to schedule during those times. But if you want to turn this off, just go ahead and set that off, and you'll see that the schedules have been added now. So it's super easy to set this up. And then we have the limits where we can set our start and end date. So we can start this off right now, or we can start it off in a week, in a month, and we have the end date too. So maybe you want to turn this off when the year ends in case you want to make some changes and you don't want to take in new schedules. You can do so by setting this up. Then you have your rolling days. You got your vacations and holidays, so you can turn days that they won't be able to schedule. Let's just say Christmas, Thanksgiving, New Year's, etc. Add those right here. Then you got your maximum appointments per day. So if someone already made an appointment, you got 2 to 3 appointments, and you don't want to take more because that's just going to take up too much of your day, well, you can set this to a limit of 5, 2, or just 1. It's up to you how you want to set this up. And the minimum scheduling notice hours. So that means that they won't be able to schedule before X amount of hours. So if it's 12 p.m. right now, they won't be able to schedule at 1 p.m. or 2 p.m. It will be after 3 p.m. So it's a great option to set this up. Then you got your advanced options. So your appointment type, a one-to-one, group, send reminder emails, and just more setup that you can set this up right here. So next thing we want to set up is the long text. So for example, additional details. Okay, so here we go. We are good to go. Now we are going to integrate with Zoom. So what we have to do is jump into settings, go to integrations, and in integrations, we are going to search for Zoom. And here it is. We're going to go ahead and select it. We have the option to create meeting, add a registration to meeting, add registration to webinar. In this case, we want to create a meeting. So let's hit next. Now we have to authenticate with our Zoom account. So let's go ahead and use another account to show you how this is going to integrate. Okay. So first off, we need to allow access to Job Form with Zoom. So they need to connect with each other in order for it to schedule meetings. So we are going to allow. Now, if you are not logged in, it will ask you to log in first. So here we go. Here's the first setup. So we got our customize your meeting title. This title is crucial so you can locate this when you have several meetings coming in to your Zoom meeting section. So we're going to remove this and we're going to keep the form title, and that is a variable. So if you change the form title later on, it's okay because it's going to be based on the title. Next, I'm going to set the next variable. So I'm going to add the name. So we got the form title and the name, so we can locate this. Now we can add more from the fields here. And if you have additional fields, you can go ahead and use those in the title too. Then we have match fields. So in this case, the start time is with the job meet. So we got to set it with the appointment, and the duration, we're going to set it to 30 because that's what we're going to use. And that's what we have set on the appointment element. Okay. Then we have choose a time zone. So this is important. In this case, it's going to be Pacific time US for me. And then we have add form fields to meeting description. So in this case, I'm going to add the additional details that I've added. Now I can add more details from the variables of the elements that we have available. But in this case, I just want to use the additional details here. Okay. So let's go ahead and save this. Here we go. It is now connected. Let's go ahead and run our first test. So let's go into preview our form. Now in my Zoom account, I don't have any meetings. I just have this webinar, which is not a meeting, but we're going to schedule one right now with this test. So I'm going to use the fill form for testing purposes. Here we go. And I'm going to use this time slot. Here we go. And I'm going to submit, right? Here we go. It is now set. Let's go ahead and jump into Zoom, and we should be seeing that meeting right now. So let's go ahead and jump over here. Let's go ahead and refresh. And here we go. We now have the meeting with John Smith, which is the title. Remember, we have the title from the form and the name from the person. And here's the meeting, 1 p.m. to 1:30 p.m. It's just a 30-minute time slot. Now I can go ahead and edit this in case I need to make some changes later on, but I can view the details here. So we got the additional details information. We got the time slot locked in, and we are good to go. So now you are able to use your form to schedule meetings on your Zoom, which is super useful. And if you need to add a participant to a Zoom meeting that's already been created or a webinar, that is possible by doing the integration here on JotForm. So go ahead and jump into add new action, and you can select add a registrant to meeting or webinar. But it's super easy to integrate your form with Zoom. So what are you waiting for? Start connecting right now. Please let me know here in the comments what you think about this integration and what you would like to see in the future. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that little bell notification to get notified when new videos come out. And that is a wrap.